stood there boldly, sweating in the sun. Felt like a million, felt like number one. The height of summer, I'd never felt that strong, like a rock.
We met in junior high when I moved to Glenwood Springs from Newcastle. I first fell in love with him when we went on a field trip for a psychology class in high school, a senior year, to the group home in Grand Junction. And I couldn't go in. I just was so sure that I was going to be so sad and at not being able to bring anybody home or fix anything. And he said, we have to go and we have to look and we have to see what we can do. So that's kind of, well, I knew that he was the right kind of guy. We were married in 1974, and yeah, Greg was still 18. We have two children, Dallas and Brandy, Drake, and we have six grandchildren.
He's been sort of always this sort of pillar in the background that's just firmly there, and I know he's there when I need him. He never pushed me in any direction, but was always really supportive, emotionally, financially, in every way, just supporting whatever I thought was good for me.
I was 18, didn't have a care, working for peanuts, not a dime to spare. But I was leaning solid everywhere, like a rock.
I've known Greg for about 20 years. I first met Greg in Rotary when I became a member in the Glenwood Sunrise Rotary Club. He just welcomed us and struck me as the type of person who cares about other people. And he serves on the education committee, scholarship committee, and he just really feels whenever there's a leadership position that's needed, he doesn't wait to be asked or need to be asked. He just kind of fills those positions, and everybody looks up to him, respects him for his fairness, his empathy, and his level-headedness.
I'm proud to claim him as a friend for the past 20 plus years, and I can understand why he has received this accolade tonight. He is a citizen not only on the local level, but also the county, state, and certainly national level. Greg sits as the regional council member on the El Pomar Foundation, and as a representative of our area, has brought numerous funds into our community for various nonprofits or charitable organizations. But my favorite part of Greg is the things that he does under the radar.
My hands were steady, my eyes were clear and bright. My walk had purpose, my steps were quick and light. And I held firm to what I felt was right, like a rock. Like a rock. I was strong as I could be. Like a rock, nothing ever got to me. Like a rock, I was something to see. Like a rock, and I stood arrow straight, unencumbered by the weight of all these hustlers and their schemes.
I met Greg in 2011 when the county commissioners asked Greg to be involved with the Garfield County Federal Mineral Lease District. That is something Greg accepted, and one time when we were driving to Denver, he just shared that this was something very important to him. Public service and giving back was something that felt good to him and something that he intended to do forever. So that was pretty inspirational, and out of Greg's leadership and as president of the Garfield County Federal Mineral Lease District, three years later, we've given away $10 million to all of the towns and cities in Garfield County, most of the school districts and special districts, and that would not have happened without Greg's leadership.
Greg takes a reasoned approach to issues and problems, both at the community and the state level. He comes across as a really confident person, and that's because he takes time to do his homework. He really works hard to understand issues and listen to people before he goes into a decision-making venue. I remember back when Greg was serving on the Glenwood Springs Planning Commission, and this was in the early 90s, I believe. There was a desalination plant proposal that had come before the city, and it was for the property that's now occupied by the base of the Glenwood Caverns Tramway. They ultimately rejected the proposal, and I often think about what our community would be like if the caverns did not have that great spot for a base area and had been squeezed into some other parcel. Our community would just be a different place today, and I think Greg Rippey is someone we can thank for that decision.
Hi Greg, I just want to say congratulations. You deserve this great honor. And so there's several stories that I've been trying to think of that I might tell. You had been playing basketball with the team for Grand River Construction, and you threw out your back and had to have some medical stuff done. You didn't sleep well at night, and you took pain pills to where a package delivered like a week later, and you had ordered your whole family monogrammed clogs and sweaters. That Merrily didn't know about and you had forgotten about. So I just remember those showing up at the house and you going, oh, wait, I know something about that. Congratulations, Greg.
As you very well know, I could tell all kinds of stories about you. But one that kind of sticks in my mind was the day we were in the backyard and the dog was barking up on the hillside there. And of course, he'd got into porcupines in the past, so we raced up there to try and intervene. I got to the top of the hill and lo and behold, he's got a skunk in his mouth. So we beat cheeks out of there, jumped off the wall, but you didn't land so good and ended up on your back, and Ike dropped the skunk right on your chest, which I thought was pretty good. We had good times growing up and working out there, and thank God OSHA really wasn't around when you and I were growing up, because some of the stuff we did wasn't all that great. Didn't comply with OSHA anyway. But anyway, thanks Greg, and keep up the good work, and congratulations, and like I said, we've had a lot of great projects together.
Okay, here's an original story about how Greg came into this world. Well, Dad and Mom were expecting their third child. They already had number one, number two, and they were expecting number three. My granny wanted a girl very much, and in fact, so much that she had already named her Daisy. Dad, for some reason, wanted a boy, but Granny wanted a girl because we were so delightful that she wanted one more. Well, Greg was born, and he sent the telegram to Granny, and it just said, Daisy is a boy. So that's how he arrived here. Daisy Greg.
Hi, Greg. Just want to congratulate you on this honor. Can't think of anyone else that truly deserves this. One of the stories I remember about you, Greg, is when you took your mechanical ability and you were on the riding lawnmower, and somehow you were up at the top of this hill with that lawnmower, and you were going down to our house to do some mowing, and somehow the brakes went out coming down, and you were just booking it down that hill, and you saved the day. You pulled the wheel and you went into the upper lot. Thank goodness that was grassed, and then just crashed. But you got right back up and started fixing things. Congratulations, Greg. Love you.
20 years now, where'd they go? 20 years, I don't know. I sit and I wonder sometimes where they've gone. Sometimes late at night, oh, when I bathe in the firelight, comes calling a ghostly way, and I recall like a rock, standing arrow straight, like a rock, charging from the gate.
Proud of you, Dad. I thank you so much for all of your support throughout the years. Like I said, you've really been a steady support throughout this, and I cannot thank you enough for all of that. Thank you.
I love you, Greg, and I'm so happy that you are part of our community.
Way to go, Greg. You really deserve this honor.
Well, Greg, I want to congratulate you on this deserving award. It's a privilege to call you my friend and mentor, and again, congratulations and continued successes.
Greg, congratulations.
Congratulations, Greg.
And I wish you the best of all as you travel near the end of the road.
Congratulations, dude. We love you.